Stephanie, how would you describe the type or theme of your food blog that you have right now?
Sure. Well, neglected. But really, my and what I love to write about and what I'm passionate about is fresh food. I'm really anti-packaged food for so many reasons, health reasons. And taste and palate and all of that. I mean, I'm very passionate about whole fresh food, and I really try to include recipes and write recipes that are original and relatively, you know, easy to pull together for someone like me, you know, a mom with a family and someone who's busy, but who wants to eat well. And by well, I mean, you know, tastes great and is fresh and whole and nutritious.
All right. Now, recently, within the past couple of years, you decided to go gluten-free in your diet. How has that affected you as far as your health, eating out, and your view of food in general?
Well, as you can imagine, it has, you know, it's not just changed my food life, it's changed my whole life. Having a lot of health problems, which is what motivated the change, and it's not been, it's so funny. I mean, I certainly like bread and pasta and products that had wheat in them before, but I've never been a baker and I've never been a dessert person, and so it's so funny the reaction I get from people. They're horrified. I mean, I think that you have a food or an ingredient that makes most people shiver to think giving up. Sugar would be one, and wheat would be the other. And that's because I do believe that it's very addictive, and so it's really hard for people to imagine letting it go. So it's probably not that fair that it really hasn't been that hard for me. And I've always been kind of a meat and vegetables and nuts and eggs, you know, kind of girl anyway. So it hasn't been that tough. And the payoff is so huge. It's just, I can't even say. I'm myself again. I was like puffy and I had gained weight and, you know, I just was not myself. And I'm myself again. And I have energy and I can sleep at night and it's just changed my life. It's, the trickiest part is eating out. Of course, it's easy to cook for myself. I can make whatever.
Right.
Very difficult eating out. I mean, you just don't have control, obviously, over what happens in the kitchen. And I'm lucky because I have a lot of friends in the industry, and they understand, and they, you know, are careful. But when we're on vacation, I mean, it's basically, I eat a lot of eggs.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to throw flour on an egg, but they want to throw flour on everything else. Piece of fish, piece of chicken, french fries, everything.
Okay. Now let's do a quick little lightning round. This is either or questions.
Okay.
First one, eating or blogging, what would you rather do?
Blogging.
Writing or photography?
Good one. Right now, photography.
Okay, Minneapolis or St. Paul?
Oh, Minneapolis.
Twitter or Pinterest?
Twitter.
And then, what's your favorite herb or spice to use currently?
Currently? I have a cardamom thing going, and that's been kind of all winter. And nutmeg. I'm using a lot of nutmeg, savory and sweet, right now.
Okay. Now, something else that you've developed about a year ago was the Minnesota Food Bloggers Group. What moved you to decide to do that, and how has that been as far as the response that you've gotten from doing that?
Right. I had the idea because I had gone to Blogger, which is this huge national conference. I went in San Francisco a couple of years ago, and I met Shayna Omundson, whose blog is Good for My Family, and Amanda Retke, whose blog is I Am Baker, there. I had never met them in Minneapolis, and I wasn't doing much with Twitter yet, and so I haven't really figured out who the other food bloggers in Minnesota were. And it just struck me so funny that, you know, I went to San Francisco and met these two amazing women, so talented, and you know, just kind of thought it'd be fun. I like to entertain, I like to have parties, and I thought it'd be fun to try to, through Twitter, figure out a way to have, you know, to have a party and have bloggers come to it. And Jill Wilson at 128 Cafe, you know, was totally game for doing this, and we did it in February of last year. And she, you know, she was fantastic. We took the tables out of the restaurant. I'm a big fan of stand-up parties. I don't believe in sitting. I believe they kill a party. So we took out the tables and had lots of great food and a cash bar. And we had 100 people sign up to come to that event.
Wow.
So it was mind-blowing.
Now, how many people do you have on the Facebook page right now of the group, roughly?
I forgot to look this morning. I think it's like 420 or something around there.
Okay.
And that's crazy and amazing. And the Facebook page is, you know, all day. All day people sharing blog posts, but asking questions and complaining and, you know, sharing photographs and funny stories and, you know, event ideas and job possibilities. It's quite an incredible thing. It's a very good use of Facebook, and it's sort of, you know, old school, sort of, as, you know, in terms of social media, but that is a particularly good use of a Facebook group.
Cool.
Yeah.